All right, today we're going to be hacking a Fuji JZ250 16 megapixel camera, and this one has the ability to do HD video, which is controlled by this button here on the bottom right corner of the back of the camera. So we're going to be hacking this camera for use as a daytime video with audio and nighttime still picture camera. So first thing we need to do is remove all the screws around the perimeter of the camera. There's two on the right hand side here, there's three across the bottom, and two on the left hand side. And need to keep all these screws in order because they are different sizes, so you want to make sure you get those back in the proper location. All right, now that we've got all the screws removed around the perimeter of the camera, need to take the camera apart, so we'll go ahead and start trying to separate the halves. You can just pop that down at the bottom and can remove that front cover. Take out your side trim pieces. And get this one out over here. There we go. And now to get the back cover off, you notice on the bottom where the mini USB plug is, you're going to have to lift that cover up over that and over the tripod hole to be able to get it to disengage. Just kind of pry that up a little bit, and then we should also on the side down here on the right side, you have to kind of lift that little tab up over that mounting hole for the screw, disengage that, and now we can take our back cover off. And then to get our top power bar off, you notice that there's three screws on it that we need to remove. One on the far right corner, and then one right here, and one right here. So we need to take those out, and then we can take that trim bar off. All right, and I got the screws out on the power trim bar up here. One thing I forgot to mention to you was whenever you take these screws out, the one on the right-hand side and the one in the middle are a little bit longer than the one on the far left side. So keep those in proper order when you put your camera back together. So now we've got the screws out, we can just lift that trim piece off and get that out of our way. And now we need to remove our LCD screen. Alright, and to get our LCD screen off, all we need to do is disengage it from the bracket that it's on. Kind of rotate that over and be careful, you don't want to tear your ribbon. And there's four mounting screws for this bracket back here that we need to take out. And you'll see those, one at the top right, bottom right, top left, and bottom left. And we need to take those screws out. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Alright, so I've got those four screws removed. And the two on the right side are a little bit longer than the two on the left side. So again, keep those in proper order whenever you can put your camera back together. And now we can take off this mounting bracket and just lift that off and get it out of our way. Now we can rotate our LCD screen back over the other direction, and you'll notice that there's a little rubber pad right here. We need to remove that. That'll give us access to a latch for our LCD ribbon, and just lift that up to disengage it, and be careful, you don't want to break it. And once you get that latch up, then you can slide that ribbon out and get your LCD screen off out of the way and set that to the side. All right, now that we've gotten our LCD screen off, it's possible to convert this camera for infrared. So if you wanted to do that, you could do that at this time, and you could remove the three screws right here that hold the CCD in place, and then lift that up and remove the cut filter that's in there, and put your screws back in to mount your CCD back in place, and you'll have it converted for infrared. Alright, now we need to get this yellow tape up out of our way so we can gain access to our power button and our shutter button so we can do the hack up there. And what you need to do is just kind of lift this up right here where it goes at the top of the flash capacitor, and then peel all that back out of your way. And be careful when doing that, because you don't want to short out that capacitor and destroy your flash or mess up the camera. So go ahead, and I'm going to get that peeled back out of the way. And now that we're to the point where we can gain access to everything that we need to do our hack on the camera, and this is our power button here, and what we're going to need is going to be the top left is going to be power, and the bottom left is going to be power common. And you could use the other side as well, the right and top and right bottom, either of those will work, but just remember that the power connection is at the top and the power common is at the bottom. Now for our shutter button over here, if you look right up here at the top, it's got a little center pad, and that is going to be your shutter common connection, and then the bottom right pad will be your shutter connection. And for our video, if you were going to do this one to do video as well, you're going to need this bottom button down here in this corner right here. And to gain access to that, you need to take these two screws out right here, and then you can kind of lift up this board a little bit to be able to get down in there to that, and I'll show you that in just a few moments. But for external microphone on this camera, you'll see it's got a black and red wire right here below this ribbon connection for the LCD. And you could desolder those two wires. The top one is going to be your microphone positive, which is the red wire, and the black wire below it is microphone negative. And I will be desoldering those and soldering on extra wires so we can run those outside the camera for an external microphone source. And to route all my wires out, what I'm going to do is right here where the tripod mounting hole is, I'm going to cut out quite a bit of this plastic right there in that area, and that will get me in a place where I can have all my wires exiting out of the camera. Alright, to show you where you can, or how to get to this video button so we can hack it, like I said, you need to remove the two screws that are on this right hand side of the main board here. And once you do that, you can kind of reach into the battery compartment and gently press out on that main board, and get you a little paper wedge that you can insert in there, and that will help keep that board positioned out some so you can get to the contacts for the video button. The bottom left contact is going to be for your video positive wire, and the one on the bottom right is the video common. The one on the right, the left, there's a little small capacitor right here close to where you've got to solder that wire on, so be careful there and try not to bridge that capacitor. And once you get those wires soldered on, then you can kind of run them right here along the bottom of the main board and across the top of your battery compartment here. And that way you try to keep from interfering with the buttons when you put the camera back together. Just bring them across over to this side and over this little mini USB port, and bring them out to your exit point there at the tripod mount. Alright, I've got my original microphone desoldered at the locations that I'll show you in just a moment. But what I've done also is went ahead and cleared out a pretty significant amount of this tripod hole here, so I can have a exit point for all of my wiring that's going to be coming out of the camera. Be careful when you're doing this, because there's a ribbon right here on this lens assembly that you don't want to cut or tear, you know, do any damage to that. And what you can do is kind of fold this lens assembly over out of your way if you need to, and you can just push on the front of it and get it start coming out, and you'll notice that there's one little catch right here at the top. This little plastic catch, just kind of lift that up, and so I'll disengage the top of that lens assembly. Let me get it turned around here, or maybe I can do that. And once you get that disengaged, then you can kind of rotate that whole assembly up out of your way, and give you a little more clearance to get down in here and work without doing any damage to this ribbon that comes across the bottom of that lens assembly. Anyway, like I said, I've already got my microphone desoldered, and when you desolder those wires, be really careful there. Don't pull on them real hard, because you don't want to lift those little solder pads that are on this main board back here. If you lift those off, then you won't have a connection point for your external mic. And so just gently pull on those as you're applying some heat to the wire, to the end of that wire, and to get it to come loose. And be careful here, you don't want to touch your iron to the ribbon for the CCD either, otherwise you'll have to replace your CCD on the lens assembly. But once you get that microphone desoldered, then you can kind of get the wires worked loose. And the microphone is over on the front, right here by the bottom of the capacitor. It's got a little rubber pad over it. Get that off, and you just kind of get in there and work that microphone out. You don't want to tear it up, because you can use this as your external microphone to run outside the camera. And that would work pretty good, but I'm going to be installing a two-wire mic, a little bit bigger mic than this one, that picks up really good. But I think this one would work fine also if you wanted to use that. But once you get that microphone out of there, then you can just get your lens assembly back into position. Like I said, be careful with the ribbons. You don't want to tear those up. Once you get it back in position, just snap it back down in place, and that's good to go there. Alright, I'm just going to show you what I've got done so far. I'm using servos for this camera, 6-wire and 4-wire, and I've already got the 6-wire servo in place. What I do is I tape it in place, and that way it allows me to wrap my wires, you know, around through the tripod hole where they're going to go, and then I can bring my wires up and snip off the excess that I don't need, and then make my solder connections. And it just helps keep it a lot neater inside the camera, so you don't have so much wire bunched up in there. But I've got my power button and my shutter button already packed, and like I said, the top left pad is going to be for power, the bottom left is for power common, and then for the shutter over here, the top middle is going to be for the shutter common, and the bottom right is for shutter. I just folded this piece of black tape that's across the top of the board here over the flash strobe tube. Just kind of peeled it up and folded it back out of the way so I can make the connection to shutter common. And then route that wire across the top of the board and around the left-hand side of the power button. And then you can fold that piece of tape back down to help hold that wire in position for you. I've already got the video button hacked also down here and ran those wires across the top of the battery compartment area, right under those two buttons here on the bottom of the main board, and across to this side and out the tripod hole area. Also, you want to keep them out of the way of this mounting screw location right here, so just be aware of that, so when you put the camera back together, you don't cut or pinch those wires right there. So and also what I did with the all of the wires is going to the top power board, is tucking them behind this ribbon right here. And maybe you can see where I have them coming up here and onto the main board or the top board, and keep them side by side so they're flat back in there, and just put a little piece of tape to keep those secure for you. So I'm gonna go ahead and get the four wire servo done, and then I'll come back. All right, I've got my four wire servo connected to the camera, and I've got it taped in place down here so I can route my wires into the tripod hole. And what I've done is I've got my external battery negative soldered on right here. Get this up here so maybe you can see that close enough. This spot right here, that's your external negative. And then on the other side of this row of header pins is the battery positive, and solder our external positive wire on there. And I've already got my speaker wires, or my microphone wires for my external microphone, soldered on down here, and got those in place. So from here, it's just going to be a matter of getting the camera back together, and then we'll test our hack. Alright, so I've got most of the camera back together now, except for putting the back cover on. And I just wanted to show you this. While we have the wires coming out of our tripod hole here, on this back cover, this area right here that would have fit around that tripod mounting hole, we need to cut off this little ring so when we put our camera back together, we don't damage our wiring. So I'll just take some little snips and cut that section off, just like that. And that way, when you put that back cover on, it doesn't cut into your wires. And if you don't do that, especially if you're using servos, you know, you won't be able to get your wires through there. And if you were just hardwiring it, it wouldn't be necessary. You could route your wires through that little hole that's on this bottom of the back cover. But I just always snip it off, whether I'm hardwiring or doing servos. So I just wanted to show you that, and I'm going to finish getting the camera back together. Alright, so now I've got my camera completely back together, and I've got my servos connected. First thing I want to do is check my external wires to make sure that I'm getting a reading from my battery. And let's see. I'll get my meter here where you can kind of see it. And let's see. So right there I'm getting a reading of 3.29, so I know that my external connections are good. Alright. So we'll get that out of the way. And now we're going to test our hack. And to power the camera on, we touch power and power common together, and our camera powers up, and then shutter and shutter common in order for it to take a picture. And we got that. And now to start video, we use our video and video common wires, touch those together, and we are now recording video. Alright guys, so that's the hack on the Fuji JZ250, and the JZ100 is the exact same hack as this camera right here. I hope this helps.